So you're in contract to purchase a home and you've requested a home warranty as a recommendation from your agent that helped you buy the property. Now, what does that home warranty cover? How does it work? That's what we're going to talk about today. I'm Jeb Smith, Coldwell Banker Residential Brokerage here in Huntington Beach. And you know, first off, I want to say thank you for taking the time to watch. Secondly, I would like to ask a request. If you find these videos helpful, do me a favor, click the like button at the end. Subscribe to my channel for more education on real estate and real estate related topics. But I'm going to get back into home warranties now. So what is a home warranty? A home warranty is essentially an agreement, a contract, if you will, with a company that will more or less cover the systems of the property, the major systems of the property, within the first year of buying a house, in most cases, right? So a home warranty is something as a buyer that you generally request as part of your purchase. You know, it's usually recommended, your agent recommends that you do it, and then as part of the contract, most times the seller agrees to it. And so today we're going to talk about what that home warranty actually covers, how you go about using it, what's not covered, all of that good stuff. So, you know, when you buy a property, from the time you close, assuming you got a home warranty, you have a year that is covered as part of that comprehensive plan, if you will, as a home warranty. And so today we're going to talk about what actually is covered in there. And so I mentioned major systems a minute ago, and that's typically what you would use a home warranty for. And one of the reasons that you would request it as a buyer when purchasing a property. So when I'm talking major systems, I'm talking appliances of the property, dishwasher, trash compactor if it has one, refrigerator, that sort of thing. So those items are included part of the major systems. In addition would be heating, air conditioning, plumbing, electrical, the water heater. Those are typically the items that we see most requested in a home warranty, and those are the items that are covered in most cases, right? So keep in mind when purchasing a home warranty plan, you need to make sure that you purchase the most comprehensive plan for all of that stuff to be included. Because if you just cover or just purchase the basic plan, or that's what's provided to you, then some of those systems, like the air conditioning, might not be included in that coverage. So you need to make sure that when you're getting the comprehensive coverage, that you're getting all of the things that you want covered as part of that home warranty. You know, some additional items could be the roof, if you want the roof covered. You know, if the home has a pool and a spa, if you want that equipment covered. Those are items that you would typically request in addition to the basic home warranty plan to make sure that they're covered, in addition to all those other systems that I mentioned initially. And, you know, keep in mind that, you know, when using a home warranty or when purchasing a home warranty, you know, with a roof, that sort of thing, they're not going to come out and replace your entire roof, right? There are limits on the amount of money that they'll spend in order to fix the repair. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's most of the time it makes sense, you know, if you're buying an older home, to ask for a home warranty, right? Because there's a lot of times if the systems are old in the house, like the heating and air conditioning, the water heater, the dishwasher, the appliances, that sort of thing, there's a chance that they could go out. And, you know, the cost of most home warranty plans, even the comprehensive plans, are $550 or so, $575. And a lot of times it makes sense to protect yourself when buying an older home, if there's a chance that those could go out within the first couple of years of owning it, because it makes sense to spend a little money if the cost of the repair or the replacement in some cases is much more. And that's going to lead us into how you would actually use it. So, you know, if you buy a property and something goes wrong, you know, if it goes wrong within the first couple of, say, days to weeks to owning the property, there's a good chance that when you file that claim with the home warranty company, and that is something that you need to do, right? You can't just go out and hire a handyman, hire a contractor to fix the repair, and then submit it to the home warranty company. Typically speaking, you've got to file a claim with the home warranty company first, at which point they will send one of their contractors out to come and assess the situation. And part of that assessment is a service fee that you have to pay as the homeowner to have those people come out. So you have the home warranty fee that is paid up front. In the case of buying a house, it's paid through escrow. But that doesn't mean that every call that you make is free. So every time you call the home warranty company to come out, there's a service fee that is in addition to that amount that was initially paid up front for the actual plan, for them to come out and assess the situation. Now keep in mind, if there's multiple things they're coming out for that requires multiple tradespeople, each one of those trades is a service fee, right? Typically speaking, that service fee is around $75. So, you know, if it's cheaper to repair the thing that's fixed, you know, if it's cheaper than $75 to actually have the repair completed and you can do it yourself, then it makes more sense to just do it yourself. You're typically going to use the home warranty on items that are more than $75, you know, because you don't want to spend more money on the service fee than it actually costs for the repair. But once you file that claim, pay that service fee, have the technician come out, they're going to tell you whether or not that item can be repaired or if it needs to be replaced. That's where the home warranty really comes into effect, because if you've got a water heater, you know, a $1,000-$1,200 item that goes out and it can't be repaired, that home warranty company is going to spend the money and actually replace it. So that's, you know, when it makes sense to have a home warranty. And a lot of cases, buying a property, it's not money that you're paying out of pocket anyway. It's being paid by the seller, so it makes a lot of sense to request it. The question is, at the end of that year, does it make sense to renew it, right? Because at the end of the year, from when you purchase the property, you have an option of renewing that home warranty and continuing to keep it in effect, or to just let it go. And once you let it go, then essentially those items would no longer be covered. Now keep in mind, you know, I've been doing this 16 years, and in this business, a lot of times a homeowner will call the home warranty company directly, and the home warranty company, you know, will have a technician come out. The technician might say that that item's not covered. Make sure as a homeowner, you know, call your real estate agent that helped you buy the property and discuss with them about the home warranty plan if that ever happens, because I've had tons of cases over the years where the home warranty company said it's not covered. They've called me, I've called my representative at the home warranty company and actually got them to cover that particular item. So, you know, as much as the home warranty company doesn't, you know, they're in the insurance business. That's what you have to remember, right? So they don't want to pay claims. They don't want to go out and do this work. And sometimes you have to go around those people to people that can actually make decisions. And sometimes it becomes a business decision depending on who you do business with, how much business you send them, et cetera, and they can get things done. You know, I'm fortunate enough to deal with top reps in the industry here in Orange County. And, you know, and when I say the top, these are the top home warranty professionals, you know, throughout the nation. And these people do a lot of business and they have a lot of say in what gets done and what doesn't get done. So make sure you're reaching out to your agent and, you know, so they can escalate things if things are taking too long. You know, I had one recently where, you know, the air conditioning wasn't working. They called the home warranty company. The home warranty company said they couldn't get out there for a week. It needed to be completed right then. I called my rep. My rep said, hey, just use anybody you want to use and send us the bill. We did that. It got fixed. All was good. So keep in mind, your real estate agent could be a very valuable resource when filing claims with home warranty companies. And also, they can kind of help guide you through that process to escalate things if necessary, like I mentioned above. So, you know, that's how you go about using your home warranty. And then lastly, you know, with selling a house, you know, I mean, I'm not sure if people selling houses are actually watching this video, but when selling a house, there is something you can do too, that I generally do on my properties, and that's a seller's home warranty. And that's something that I pay for the sellers. And what it does is it's coverage for the basically the major systems of the houses of the house, not including the appliances, that protects them during the escrow process or during the listing process. So if something breaks during the listing process, like the dishwasher, the water heater, or something like that, it's actually covered. You know, it may come up in the home inspection or what have you, but we just file a claim with the home warranty company. They'll come out, repair it, what have you, saves the seller a ton of money from not having to fix it, especially while it's being listed and they have additional things going on. So, you know, if you're selling a house, there is a way to protect it during that period as well if you don't have a home warranty already in place. So I hope that's helpful. You know, there's a lot of ins and outs with home warranties. There's a lot of things they will cover. You know, there's a lot of things they won't cover. But keep in mind, you know, if you have questions about that sort of thing, talk to your real estate agent. Let them, you know, talk to their representative and see if there's things that can get done. Because again, I've had claims denied that have come back to me and I've able to get them done and get people, you know, money and items replaced. So thank you for watching. You know, if you have additional questions about home warranties, you know, you can contact me directly or you can just comment below. I'm happy to address them. And as always, I appreciate you taking the time to watch and we'll see you again soon. Have a great day. Bye-bye.